And a very good day. So today we will look at this new chapter, which is our chapter 11 in this book. Okay, chapter 11, friction force. I noted there category 1 and 2. Okay, so category 1 and 2, because as long as our syllabus is concerned, we go more on category 1 and 2. In this book, we have about category up to category 6 or 5, something like that. Okay, but we will cover, my lecture will cover up to category 2 only. So before we go to the category 1 and 2, we look at what is friction force. Okay, if there is a component putting on a surface, okay, and we pull by a force P, okay, if the force is small, the component will not move. Why is it not move? Because there are something which we call it as a friction force that oppose the direction of the motion. If the surface is frictionless, if you put even the small forces, even the small force, the component will directly move because there is no friction. If there is friction opposing the direction of the motion, then the component will not move until one point, meaning that the force given is much bigger than friction force, and then the component will start moving. Okay, so the equation is here, the F is the friction, okay, equal to mu times N. Okay, so the N is the normal force and mu is the coefficient of friction. Okay, so the N, if you draw this free body diagram, you will have here P mg F and N. Okay, so we have a mass here. So by this simple calculation, we see that we have the mass M N equal to mg. Okay, N equal to mg, and then we have P equal to F, opposite direction. Okay, so F calculate by using this equation, mu N. So you put the N from this calculation, you get the mu. Okay, so how we measure the mu? Okay, actually the mu is measured from this type of experiment. Okay, so we have this type of experiment where we have one component attached to the string. Okay, so down here we have we put a load. Okay, we put a load, it is a surface. We want to know what is the coefficient of friction between this surface and the other surface. Okay, it's always between the two surfaces. The different surface will give you different friction, coefficient of friction. So you want to know what is the coefficient of friction between this first surface and the second one. So you put the surface with mass M on this one, and then we'll pull by using this cable. Okay, using the knowledge that a cable going past through pulley will have the same tension, and here the mass here is known, so you have mass 1 times G equal to P, force P. Okay, so once you draw the free body diagram, you will have this type of free body diagram where you have, okay, this will be equal to here, so the P, you know the P equal to M1 times G. Okay, so here you have mg, and then you have the N, and you have the friction, which is mu times N, F equal to mu times N. Okay, so what we'll do is friction force. What we will do is we will add the mass here. Okay, we'll add the mass here until the component start moving. The last adding mass, okay, the last value of mass before the component start moving is this one, F max. We call it F max. So the last point before the component start moving, we add smaller. The smaller the mass adding, the more precision it will be. So the mass adding here, the maximum, F maximum before the component start moving, will be used to calculate the value of mu. Okay, so mu, we have the mu, F is known from here, P, or F equal to P from this equilibrium, sigma Fx. b equal to f, and then we have divided by this n, we get the value of mu. So that's how we calculate the value, or we measure the value of coefficient of friction force from the experiment. Okay, so going back from this one, also from here, I will just draw a simple free-body diagram here. Okay, so to replace this figure, okay, which is the same as this one. Okay, so now here is okay. So if, so let's say this is force, friction force here, and then this is the P, force that pull the cable. Okay, so let's say if we have this M, and pulling by force, what I have here in my, okay, for example, for the first one we have P equal to 10 Newton, okay, the F, V equal to 0. Okay, so if in equilibrium, if I pushing, if I pulling with the force P, a component with mass M, and the system is not moving, in equilibrium we have sigma Fx equal to 0, so we have P or F equal to also 10 Newton, but this direction, opposite direction from this one. Okay, so if I'm drawing it here, if this is P 10, the F also 10, so I will have here, this is the first point, okay, P and F same, and then I will add the force, P equal to 20 Newton, for example, so I have the F, okay, but if the component is not, still not moving, so at same, we will have the F equal to P, okay, so F, now this is F, 10, this is 20, this is 20, have about same point, this is 20, this is also 20. Okay, so adding more, let's say we add one more, P equal to 30 Newton, V equal to still 0, so we have F opposite direction, as long as the component is not moving, so the friction force F is equal to the go to the P, the force that pulling to do the other direction, because it is in equilibrium. So I have here 30. Here must also be 30. So if I'm drawing this, this will be this point. Okay. Until I reach one point, I put the force, for example, force P equal to what? No? P equal to 60 Newton. For example. And now the component start moving. V equal to 0.1 meter over second. Okay. Now the component start moving. Okay. So we have F here. Once the component start moving, the F is no longer same value as the P. Okay. It's no longer same value as the P, because it's no more in equilibrium. Okay, so but there must be one point where the component had reached the limit before it start moving. So let's say I have this one is the maximum component. Maximum P equal to 58 Newton, for example. I have F, V still equal to 0. So let's say this is the maximum point, 58 Newton given before component start moving. If I'm given 59 Newton, it will already move. So this will be your maximum point. So here, last point, 58 and 58. So once you draw the graph, you will see that it is a linear graph. Okay, it is a linear graph. But once it is start moving, the value of F and P will be no longer the same value. So this region here, up to here, is equilibrium or static. Okay, so here it is in motion, moving. Okay, so in this case, here up to this point, okay, so this is static, equilibrium. Okay. So after this, it is in motion. Okay, so if you see most of the graph for the friction, most of the material we give the graph, this is straight, and after that it will shoot a little bit before go a straight line. Okay, this is a straight line. Okay, so this is the typical graph for a friction force. So this is a friction force. I'm name it as a F. I'm not taking this one as mu n or mu s or mu k n. No, I'm putting here just F, the friction force. Okay, because the mu n, mu s, and mu n, this is specific for several point, not the whole component. So here I'm doing only the F. Okay, so the maximum point before it start moving here, this is the maximum point before it start moving, which is this point. We call it as F max, which is here. F max. And this value of F max is equal to mu static times n. Okay, the F max there is equal to mu static times n, because in the test, or you will see that there will be two mu, which is mu static and mu kinetic. Experiment that I've shown you before is to find the mu static. Okay, so we find the what is the value of mu static. Okay, not before it's moving, we cannot find the mu. Mu is only the coefficient maximum value before it moves. So this is the F max mu static times n. This is the value of mu. So there you will see a lot of these two, mu static and mu kinetic. And normally you will have mu static is bigger than mu kinetic. Okay, so this value here, F for moving equal to mu kinetic times n. Because of this value, you will see that this value is a little bit higher than the component, the force when it move. Once it is moved, the friction force will be constant as mu kinetic times the n. Okay, so you really need to understand before it move. Okay, the value of friction force will be same as value of force pushing or pulling the component the opposite direction until it reach the maximum. The maximum is equal to mu sn. It is the maximum friction force. After that, this value will down a little bit and it become a mu kinetic at the region where the component is moving. So you please understand this, because in the next part we will use this understanding in our calculation. Okay, what is the value of actual friction force and so on. The question will ask you normally, we give the condition and you have to determine either the component is moving or not. Okay, let's say it is not moving, and what is the value of friction? You cannot put, if it is not moving, you cannot put the value equal to this one, because it is still not moving. So you have to put the value equal to actual value before it moving. If it is moving, the value is equal to this one. So you really have to understand this condition. Before it move, before it reach the maximum, the value of friction force same as the force pulling the component. After that is equal to mu k times s. This is the maximum before it move. Okay, so this is the part of understanding you really need to master before we go to the next step. Okay, so we go to problem later on, or how to solve the problem involving friction force. Okay, so like I said, we have two category, the category 1 and category 2. Category 1 here is we are given a condition, but the question didn't say either the component is in equilibrium or moving, static or moving. So you have to determine it is in static or in equilibrium, and normally you are required to find what is the value of friction force. If it is static, you know from the graph that I draw. If it is kinetic or moving, what is the value of friction force? That is the first category. We didn't know moving or not moving. The second condition, second category, the question will directly tell you that the system is in equilibrium. Normally you will have to find what is the value of force or friction or something to maintain the system equilibrium. So you have the lower limit, and also the upper limit of the system, either force or friction or something, to maintain the system in equilibrium. Okay, so there's two cases. So the first one, we have category one. We didn't know it is in motion or static. So what we have, we from here we have four conditions. The first one is moving or static. Okay, and if we have this condition normally, okay, we put this condition. We have angle something. So the other part is, if it is moving, which direction? Up or down? If it is static, let's say static, because this one, the question that I put here before, P, even though we put a small P, it is not moving, but still it has a tendency to move because the force pulling this direction. So it has the tendency to move to the right, because it is pulling to the right. So same as this one, even though it is static, so it has the tendency to move. Which direction? Up or down? Okay, so we will have four conditions: moving upward, moving downward, or static equilibrium that have the tendency in the verge of moving upward or in the verge of moving downward. So you have that four category. Okay, four condition. So the condition problem will give to you, and then you have to analyze it is static or moving, which direction, and you have to calculate the actual friction force. Okay, so we have several simple steps to follow. The first one, calculate or determine the value of N and F. Okay, you know that you have this one is mg, you know this one is N, this is F. Okay, so from this calculation, I will not write here as mu s or mu n, mu k n. I will just put it as F. Okay, because we still not know. If it is not moving, the F is not a mu n, it is only the friction force. And we have seen from the graph that I'm showing you before this one. Okay, so we'll put it as F, first one. Okay, this one we use sigma fy equal to 0, and then we will, the second one, we compare this F with F max. Okay, remember the graph, this is F max. Okay, which is F max, which is equal to mu statics times N. Okay, so you compare the F. Okay, so I call it this one F is, or F calculated, the one that we calculate, equal to mu with the mu Fm. Okay, we will compare this one. Okay, if F, this one, F calculated, bigger than Fm, so the component is moving. If this L is less or equal than Fm, the component is static. Okay, how you understand this one? Looking from this graph that I've already shown you. Okay, so if F is the calculated one, this F or F, okay, bigger than F maximum, so the component is moving, it is less or equal than F maximum, it is in equilibrium. And normally the question will ask you the actual friction force. Okay, actual friction force, so I'm putting as F actual. The question is, we ask you, either the component is moving or in equilibrium, which direction? And lastly, what is the actual friction force? Okay, so if the component is moving, the actual friction force will be, okay, looking from this figure, this is the direction where the component is moving. So you have F equal to mu kinetic times n. So the actual friction force is equal to mu kinetic times n. If it is static, the F actual, okay, the F actual is equal to F that you calculate, because if this is not moving, okay, this is where you calculated, you calculate, this is F that you calculate, so the actual friction force is actually this one, because this is still not moving, so you have to moving the force, the actual friction force will be this one, if not moving, is the one that you have calculated. So that's the simple step. First one, you calculate the friction force, okay, and then compare with the maximum. If it is more than the maximum, then it moves. If it is less, it is not moving. If it is moving, the friction force is mu kn. If it is moving, if it is not moving, the friction force is the one that you have already calculated. Okay, so that's the simple step. We will look more on when you go to the example.